Hello students, today I will be talking on respiratory mechanism and renal mechanism in acid-base balance. The question can be asked as pH balance, it will be the same thing. First, I will be talking on respiratory mechanism in acid-base balance. The second line of defense against acid-base disturbance is by regulating the concentration of carbonic acid, that is H2CO3, in the blood and other body fluids by the lungs. This is a respiratory mechanism, is a rapid mechanism. Respiratory center regulates the removal or retention of carbon dioxide and thereby H2CO3 from extracellular fluid by the lungs. That is, this H2CO3 is formed by CO2 and H2. So if CO2 is either removed or retained, then it affects the H2CO3. Thus, by regulating the rate of pulmonary ventilation through chemoreceptors, PCO2, that is the partial pressure of carbon dioxide, is regulated by the lungs. Bicarbonate neutralizes 50% of all acids stronger than carbonic acid. Carbon dioxide formed is readily eliminated by lungs, thus functions by maintaining one component, that is H2CO3 of major buffer. Buffer is in the ratio should be maintained in the HCO3 upon H2CO3. So if H2CO3 is maintained, that is in the form of carbon dioxide, if it is expelled or retained, then the ratio changes. Okay, so I'll show you in the next slide how it occurs. So, if there is an increase in blood carbon dioxide, so carbon dioxide combines with water to form H2CO3. So, carbonic acid increases and that's why this will lead to an increase in hydrogen ion. That means the ratio HCO3 upon H2CO3 decreases and that means there is a decrease in pH. Because there is an increase in hydrogen, that means there is a decrease in pH. So now when there is a decrease in pH, this will stimulate the respiratory center located in medulla that increase the depth and rate of ventilation. So more carbon dioxide is released from blood in lungs as the rate of ventilation increases. And thus, when carbon dioxide is released, so H2CO3 will decrease. And that's why HCO3 upon H2CO3 ratio changes and that will lead to an increase in the pH. Similarly, there is a decrease in respiratory ventilation when OH or HCO3 increases. That means when there is alkalosis, there is a decrease in ventilation. When there is acidosis, there is an increase in the rate of ventilation. So in acidosis, carbon dioxide will be released, while in alkalosis, carbon dioxide will be retained. So when carbon dioxide is released, the ratio will change and it will try to restore the pH. And that's why from the low pH, it will try to increase the pH, because the ratio changes as carbon dioxide is released. The opposite will occur in alkalosis. Alkalosis, there is an increase in pH. So when carbon dioxide is retained, the pH, it will, for compensation, the pH will be decreased. That will be the compensation. Ventilation rate can change from 0 to 15 times normal. And there can be a significant regulation of HCO3 upon H2CO3 ratio. But this respiratory regulation is a temporary basis. Renal mechanism is the permanent restoration. Thus, rate of ventilation increases when there is an increase in acid, then the excess H2CO3 in the form of carbon dioxide is quickly removed. Similarly, when rate of ventilation decreases, acid H2CO3 in the form of CO2 is added to neutralize excess alkali, that is the HCO3. Now coming to the renal mechanism in acid-base balance. Renal mechanism is the third line of defense in acid-base balance. Buffer was the first, second was respiratory, and third is the renal mechanism. It's a long-term acid-base control and it is exerted by renal mechanism. This is a permanent solution for pH balance. It is in contrast to the temporary buffer and the short-term respiratory mechanism. Kidney participates by conservation of HCO3, that is the alkali reserve, and excretion of acid. Besides excreting or reabsorbing acid or the basic substance as the situation demands. The pH of the interglomerular filtrate is approximately 7.4. It is same as that of the plasma, whereas the average urinary pH is approximately 6 due to the renal excretion of non-volatile acids produced by the metabolic processes. The pH of urine can vary from 4.5 to 8 depending upon it is acidosis or alkalosis. If it is acidosis, there is excretion of acid increases and base are conserved, while the opposite occurs in alkalosis. Renal conservation of HCO3 and excretion of acid occurs through four key mechanisms. The four mechanisms are exchange of hydrogen or excretion of hydrogen for sodium of tubular fluids. Reabsorption or reclamation, that means recovery of bicarbonate from tubular fluid. Formation of ammonia and excretion of ammonium ions in the urine. Excretion of hydrogen ions as H2PO4 in urine. That is a phosphate buffer. First mechanism is the excretion or exchange of hydrogen for sodium of tubular fluids. This picture depicts, this is the renal tubular cells, this is the tubular lumen, and this is the plasma. In the renal tubular cells, the carbonic anhydrase catalyzes the formation of H2CO3 from H2O and CO2. This H2CO3 then dissociates into H+ and HCO3. H ions in the tubular cells are secreted into the tubular lumen in exchange for sodium. Sodium and hydrogen exchange is enhanced in the state of acidosis and inhibited in state of alkalosis. This hydrogen, which is secreted out into the tubular lumen, then can combine with any base and then excreted out into the urine. The bicarbonate ions formed by the dissociation of H2CO3 in the tubular lumen diffuses into the blood and is as the accompanying of the sodium ions. So sodium and this bicarbonate is thus conserved, and this increases the alkali reserve of the body. Next mechanism is reabsorption of bicarbonate. Here also, in presence of carbonic anhydrase, H2CO3 is formed, which then dissociates to form H+ and HCO3. This H+ is then secreted out into the tubular lumen, which is then in exchange for the sodium. The sodium is taken up into the plasma. This hydrogen ion then reacts with the bicarbonate in the tubular fluid to form H2CO3. And this H2CO3 then forms dehydrates to form carbon dioxide and H2O in presence of carbonic anhydrase, And this carbon dioxide then diffuses into the renal tubular cells. There it again forms H2CO3, then dissociates into H plus and HCO3. This HCO3 then is reabsorbed, and this is the alkali recovered. So this HCO3 will be reabsorbed. This is enhanced in condition of when there is the state of acidosis, while this is decreased in alkalosis. The kidney reabsorbs almost all the filtered bicarbonate, and keeping the plasma bicarbonate level at 25 milliequivalent per liter. But if the bicarbonate level increases above 25 milliequivalent per liter, only then it will be excreted into the urine. So that was about the reabsorption of bicarbonate. The next mechanism is excretion of titrable acid by phosphate buffer. The fixed acids generated during metabolism are also excreted by kidney as titrable acids. Here also, if you see, the H2CO3 is formed in, and then it will dissociate to form H plus and HCO3. Here also, if you see the hydrogen ions, they are secreted into the lumen, and at the same time, sodium are reabsorbed into the plasma. The hydrogen ions or the protons generated by this carbonic anhydrase mechanism, this hydrogen are secreted into the lumen, which is then combines with the HPO4 to form NaH2PO4. This is the major titrable acid in the urine. This is sodium dihydrogen orthophosphate, which is then excreted into the urine, and the active secretion of hydrogen ions acidifies the urine and changes the pH from 7.4 to less than 6 pH. The more and more the hydrogen ions are secreted into the lumen, the pH becomes more and more acidic as it passes through the tubules. Here also, if you see, the bicarbonate is recovered along with the sodium. It is reabsorbed into the plasma. This mechanism is the excretion of ammonium ions. Here also, the hydrogen ions are secreted into the lumen, and at the same time, sodium are reabsorbed in exchange for the sodium. Here, ammonia, the urinary buffer, is produced by the deamination of glutamine in the renal tubular cells by the enzyme glutaminase to form glutamate and ammonia. This ammonia is the urinary buffer of the renal tubules, and this ammonia, it will easily diffuse into the tubular lumen, where it buffers the hydrogen ions. The ammonium ions formed in the tubular lumen cannot diffuse back into the tubular cells, and thus are trapped and excreted with the anions such as phosphate, chloride, or sulfate. In metabolic acidosis, the excretion of ammonium ions by the kidney is increased several folds. And here also, if you see, the bicarbonates are reabsorbed along with the sodium. So the alkali is recovered when there is more acidosis. The hydrogen ion are secreted out, and at the same time, alkali is reserved along with the sodium ions. So that was the four renal mechanism by which acid-base balance can occur. Thank you so much. Those who haven't subscribed, please do subscribe, and please do like my videos.